us into spiritual fellowship and covenant relations with God and one another.
Every day, as we leave, by the Spirit of God, to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior, and on the profession of our faith, have been baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. We unite in the presence of our God,
and angels in this assembly, most solemnly and joyfully, in his covenant
with one another, and as one body in Christ.
What are some of our privileges and duties in this, our church?
We engage everyone by the aid of the Holy Spirit to walk together in Christian love, to strive for the advancement of this church in knowledge and hope, to
give it a place in my operation,
for the presence of the Lord, every occupation,
to the saints, worship, discipline, and doctrine.
What vows do we gladly make as stewards of that God has entrusted us?
To the church and the remnant that God has prospered us towards his presence, for the support of faithful and faithful ministry among us, the reading of the Lord, and the spread of the gospel over all nations.
For the sake of our home, church, and loved ones, what task do we humbly assume?
In case of difference of opinion in the church, we will act in order to teach the Spirit, and then we can act as the Spirit. We will cheerfully recognize the right of the majority to govern. We also engage to maintain the land of secret devotion, to study good in the Word of God, the riches of the gift of our children, and to seek salvation of our kingdom and righteousness.
For the sake of the unsaved for whom Christ died, to what manner of life and conversations are we solemnly pledged?
To walk such as faithfully in the world, to be God and just in our living, faithfully in our engagement, endeavoring truly in our heart, and goodwill towards all of you, to exemplify and be in our holy faith, to avoid all traffic, backbiting, excessive anger, to abstain from the sins of the sins of our faith, bringing in the room.
Since one is our master, even Christ, and all we brother, by what fraternal ministries are we to strengthen each other and adorn the teachings of our Lord and Savior?
We brotherly engage to watch over one another in brotherly love, to remember each other in prayer, to aid each other in sickness and distress, to cultivate Christian sympathy and building courage and speech, to be slow to take offense, but always ready for reconciliation, in mind of who is our Savior, in the 18th chapter of Matthew, to secure it without delay.
All, we moreover engage that when removed from this place, we will as soon as possible, that is the Father Church, where we can carry out the spirit of this covenant and the principle of God's word. You may be seated. At this time, we're going to prepare for offerings. We're going to take mission, tithe, offerings at this time. Please remember our scholarship fund. Malachi 3, verses 8, 9, and 10 says, will a man rob God? Yet he hath robbed thee. But he said, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithe and offerings. Ye are cursed with a curse, for ye have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in thine house, and prove me not. Now, herewith, said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven, and pour you out a blessing, there shall not be room enough to receive our tithe, offering, and funds, and as well as our general offerings at this time, please. Ushers are in charge.
Thank you.
building and upkeep of the sanctuary, Lord. For your kingdom, Lord. We pray that in the name of your Son, Jesus, by your name.
Thank you. Thank you. want to give the Lord a hand clap, please. Come on, we can do it with the other one. And we're grateful for his mercy. Can we say amen? Amen. We bless the Lord today. For he is good to us. Amen. We have so much to be thankful unto him for. Amen.
Amen.
And we're yet praising him for his love and kindness toward us. Amen. Bow your heads with me, if you will. Eternal God, again we say thank you. And again we bless you. Again, we magnify you. For you being God in our lives, we thank you, Lord, for bringing us to the first Sunday in this 10th month of this year of 2020. We say thank you for your goodness and your mercy. Thank you for how you came and gave your life that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Now, Lord, speak through us and use us as you will. Let the words of my mouth, the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. For, Lord, you are my strength. You are my redeemer. It is in the name of Jesus our Christ we ask it all, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Amen. Amen. And amen. 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 For the blessings of the Lord. Amen. And for how he's yet blessing us right now. We can't thank him enough for his goodness and his mercy in our lives. I do give all praise and glory to the Lord our God and thankful that he is our Savior, that he is our keeper. We thank God for each of you in your respectful place. You have your Bible, turn with me to Mark chapter 14. Mark chapter 14. Look with me if you will. Around verse number 32. Verse 32. Mark chapter 14. Mark 14. Amen. Mark 14. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
And they came to a place which was named Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, "Sit ye here while I pray." Take it with him, Peter and James and John, and began to be sore amazed and to be very heavy, and said unto them, "My soul is exceeding sorrowful unto death. tarry ye here and watch. Verse 35 says, and he went forward a little and fell on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said, Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee. Take away this cup from me. Nevertheless, not what I will, but what thou wilt.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And he cometh and findeth them sleeping. And said unto Peter,
yes.
Simon, sleepest thou? Couldest not thou watch 1 hour? Watch ye and pray, lest ye enter into temptation. That the spirit truly is ready, but the flesh is weak. And again he went away and prayed and spake the same words. And when he returned, he found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. Neither wist they what to answer him. Verse 41, and he cometh the third time and said unto them, sleep on now and take your rest. It is enough. The hour is come. Behold, the Son of Man is betrayed into the hand of sinners. Verse 42 said, rise up, let us go. He that betrayeth me is at hand. Can we say amen? Can we say amen again? Say amen one more time. Praise his name. No! say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I look at the time of brevity here today in the study of the Gospel of Mark. Will bring us even closer to the moment when the Lord Jesus will give his life for sin and sinners on the cross. My brothers and sisters, as Jesus approaches that hour, events in his life begin to move forward in an incredible pace.
Yes, sir.
As these last events unfold in our Lord's life, we are allowed to witness some of the most heinous and most holy events being played out side by side. Y'all pray with me just a short while. The passage before us today is one of the most holy. As we join Jesus and his men once again, they are in the midst of an eventful night. First, they have just finished the Passover celebration. According to verses 12 through 26. They left the room where they celebrated the Passover and made their way from Jerusalem down through the Kidron Valley to a place called Gethsemane.
Yes.
On the way to Gethsemane, Jesus discussed with his disciples all of the great truths contained in John chapters 14 through chapters 17. He taught them about heaven. He taught them about the peace of God. He taught them about surrender to the Lord. He taught them about the coming of the Holy Spirit. And he prayed the wonderful and powerful prayer of John 17. All of this occurred as they made their way to the garden called Gethsemane. The text today focuses in on what happened at Gethsemane. And I would like for us to spend just a short while today considering what took place in that garden that night. On that night, Gethsemane became more than a garden where Jesus and his men spent some time. On that night, Gethsemane became a place where eternal business was transacted for the glory of God. So if you will, let's just look at this passage of scripture and let's see what happens here. When we look at verse 32 through 34, it points out to us or lets us know that this place became a place of pressure. Praise his name. Lord, help me here today.
Yes.
The name of this garden was Gethsemane. It probably belonged to a friend of the Lord. While it is famous in our day and still exists just outside of the city of Jerusalem, In the Lord's day, it was probably a small garden enclosed by a wall and guarded by a gate. It was a place Jesus often visited with his men. And Gethsemane seemed to have been a place of refuge for the Lord. It was a place where he could find solitude from the crowds and ministry that occupied his life. It was a place where he could go to find a private moment to commune with his Father. It was a sanctuary from the attacks of his enemy. It was a place of refreshment from the long day of ministry. It was a special place for the Lord and his followers. Praise the Lord. Gethsemane is Arabic in origin. The word means olive press.
All right.
Praise his holy name. If you don't mind, just say that olive,
olive
press.
Yes.
Gethsemane was and it was a place where olive trees grew and produced their fruit. I hope you're walking.
Yes.
The olives were collected when it came time for them to come off the tree, placed in a press.
Oh, yes.
And the precious olive oil was extracted from the olives under intense pressure.
Yes.
Lord have mercy.
My Lord.
Jesus and his men arrived in Gethsemane. He leaves eight of the disciples at the gate of the garden. He takes Peter, James, and John with him.
Yes.
Y'all walk with him.
Yeah.
And they go deeper into the garden. Say that deeper.
Deeper.
Why were these men singled out? It seems that they were the leaders among the group, that they would see and hear things that would serve them as they led the other disciples in the future. Jesus gave these three a time of special ministry so they could be used to help others to grow. And by the way, the Lord still does that today.
Yes, yes.
Do I have a witness here?
Yes.
Praise his holy name. He will put some of his people in the situation where they can see, hear, and experience things others can't imagine. Praise the Lord. How and why he does it so is the fact that they might use them when the time comes to teach others about the power of his grace and sufficiency.
Yeah.
On that night, our Lord would enter the olive press.
Yes.
Right, have a witness here.
Amen.
And the sweet oil of grace and submission to the Father would be extracted from the Lord's life for Jesus. And then the Garden of Gethsemane would be a place of intense pressure. And our text tells us about some of the pressure he faced that night.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I had somebody. Do I have a witness here? There were internal pressures. The very language of these verses reveal the truth that Jesus is in a time of intense emotional and spiritual trial. I hope y'all walking with me. Huh? It said he was sore amazed. This phrase means to be struck with terror. I wish I had somebody here. The word had the idea of a terrified surprise. Jesus knew what was coming, but as he looked into the cup that he was about to drink, he was astonished and overcome with horror. No other human had ever experienced such anguish of soul as that which came upon him. My brothers and sisters, life can throw some hard terror toward us.
Yes.
Do I have a witness here?
Yes.
sometimes we can come up against some things in life that overwhelms us. And we really don't understand why it's happening. But look, it's allowing you to see what you're going to have to go through.
Look,
just because you're saved does not mean that you won't have some hardship in this life. Just because you're saved does not mean that you won't come against some things and the enemy won't come at you and try to overtake you. But I come to tell you that now that you know for yourself that you have Jesus on board, you have somebody to help you go through. I have a witness here.
Amen.
Every phase of life, I wish I had somebody walking through me. Every phase of life takes you, should take you a little higher. Should get a little more intense. But I have a witness here. When you was a baby, you didn't have nothing to worry about. Because mom and daddy took care of everything. Somebody ought to say amen. When you were a child, you didn't have anything to worry about. Because you didn't have to worry about where the food was going to come from.
Yeah.
You didn't have to worry about where you were going to lay your head.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't have to worry about clothes being on your back.
Yes.
Mom and daddy provided all of that.
Yes.
When you got to be a teenager, you thought to yourself, I'd like to make my own money.
Yeah.
So I can do what I want.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Some of us wanted our own money so we could spend it like we wanted to.
Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Buy what we wanted, Isaac. When we got good and ready. But then mom and daddy sometimes would interrupt your thought process and tell you, you're going to bring that money home with me. Somebody ought to say amen. And they would take so much of that money and help you to understand, and praise the Lord, that when you get out on your own, you ain't going to be able to spend it just like you want. There comes responsibility with being grown. Praise his holy name.
Amen.
Well, I didn't get many amen.
Amen.
But I know I'm right.
Yes.
Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
And when by chance you happen to, praise the Lord, happen to get a child in your home or some children in your home that really want to get out there and work and really want to get out there and make their money and didn't want to foot their own, praise the Lord. Y'all got quiet, so evidently that ain't happened to too many. Praise this holy name. Hallelujah. Want to buy their own clothes. Want to take care of their own bills. Somebody ought to say to me, if by chance your parents were able to bless you with a car and you wanted to pay the insurance and the car payment yourself, if it wasn't paid for it. All of those various things. If by chance a parent happened to get a child like that, they tell the Lord, thank you. Because they're seeing the need to take on responsibility.
Yeah.
But with everything comes pressure.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yes, it does.
I wish somebody would walk in.
Yes.
See, sometimes we want some things that we ain't ready for.
Amen.
Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes when we get some of the things that we think we're ready for, we realize I ain't as ready as I thought I was.
Yes.
Now, Lord, I need you to help me. I'm in it now. Somebody say I'm in it now. I'm in it now, and I gotta stick this thing out. I gotta go through with it. I gotta make sure I go through. I don't wanna falter. I don't wanna drop the ball because I wanna be able to be an overcomer.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise his holy name. With every phase in life, as I foresee, comes pressure. But sometimes there are some pressures that you know gonna come. But when they come, they overwhelm you. Do I have a witness? They kind of terrify you. Even though, praise the Lord, when you look and you really, you already knew, praise the Lord, that when I get out here, I'm gonna have to pay my own rent. Hello? If I get a car, I'm going to have to pay my own car payment.
Yes.
I'm going to have to pay my insurance. I'm going to have to keep gas in the car. I'm going to have to keep upkeep on the car. Praise the holy name of Jesus. When I get in my own place, I got to pay light bill.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just using this as an example. example. I got to pay. I got to take care if you happen to have an electric stove. Thank God that that's all included with the light bill. But if you happen to have a stove that's gas, then you got another bill added on called a gas bill. Yeah. Then if you happen to get somewhere where the water ain't included in the rent, then you have to pay water bill. Do I have a witness here? And then if you want a phone, it used to be if you wanted a phone in the house, praise the Lord. But now we're so used to, and we have, the Lord has, well, he blessed technology to happen. So and sometimes I say, I wonder, is it good for us or has it become a curse to us? Amen. That we now have these cell phones. And praise the Lord, now you don't have to worry about waiting until you get back home to see who called you. They can call you while you're in Walmart. Somebody ought to say that. Even if you happen to be sitting up in Disney World, they can call you. Somebody ought to say that. If you happen to be sitting up in Ruth Chris in a romantic dinner with a friend or something of that nature, Tina, Lord have mercy, they still can call you. And then the thing about it, praise the Lord, is you now you get to see who called you. And you can determine whether you want to answer. Y'all might well say amen. Y'all don't sit up here and tell that tale now. Because y'all know y'all done looked at that phone and said, I call him back then. Somebody ought to say amen. But I'm coming to tell you today, praise the Lord. All of that requires or comes with what is called pressure. Pressure to meet those bills. Pressure to make sure that ends meet. Somebody ought to say amen. And sometimes you have to cut back on some things because you realize you don't have enough to meet it all. So now you got to prioritize. But Jesus comes to this point, my brothers and sisters, of realizing I know I came in order that I might go and redeem mankind. I know I came in order that I might go to the cross. But the Bible lets us know that when he gets to this point, he becomes so amazed, he becomes so heavy under pressure. About what he's about to go through, that it overwhelms him, it terrifies.
Yes, yes.
That's the fleshly side.
Uh-huh.
Somebody said that's the fleshly side.
That's
see, the fleshly side said, Lord,
uh-huh.
God,
uh-huh.
Father,
uh-huh.
I don't want to go through this.
Uh-huh.
If it be your will, take this cup from me. Somebody ought to say amen. Flesh said, I don't want to have to pay this. I don't want to have to undergo this. But then when the spiritual man gets strength, I wish I had somebody walking. Praise the Lord. When the Lord blesses you and gets some strength, you say, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. Lord, I don't like this, but nevertheless, not my will. Thy will.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I wish I had somebody.
Yeah.
Thy will. Thy will. Somebody ought to say thy will.
Yeah.
The Bible says he was very heavy,
uh-huh.
Which speaks of a condition of great distress and anguish. He said, my soul is exceeding sorrowful.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
This phrase literally means to be overwhelmed with sorrow.
Yeah.
Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Yeah, yeah. We get a out of this. Yeah. The means and the understanding to be surrounded.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus was surrounded by overwhelming sorrows. And he said, I'm so sorrowful, even unto death.
Yes.
Lord, help me here today. He says, even unto death. This phrase means that Jesus was at the point of death.
Uh-huh.
He prayed in Gethsemane.
Yes.
It is possible for a person to die of anguish alone.
Mm-hmm.
The Word of God is telling us that Jesus was overwhelmed emotionally and spiritually by what he experienced as he entered the Garden of Gethsemane that night, thinking about the pressure the Lord was under. He knows he's about to suffer intense physical pain. He knows that he's about to come to become sin on the cross. He knows that he's about to be judged by his Father. He knows that for the first time in eternity, there will be a breach in the unbroken fellowship he has enjoyed with his Father. He knows that he will be abandoned by his nation. His Father was at his Father. He knows that he's about to be tried, rejected, and condemned to death by the very people he came to save. He knows that he, amen, that the most powerful human government on earth was about to turn fury upon him. He knew it. He knew it. Lord, I wish I had some. He knows it. He knows it. He knows it. The thought of what he was about to endure literally overwhelmed his mind.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And his heart. It was a time of extreme intense pressure. Thank God, my brothers and sisters, that he endured the spiritual and emotional trial and made it to Calvary so that we might be saved.
Yes.
Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Can you say amen? My brothers and sisters, there was external pressure. When we read, I gotta get this point. When we read Luke's account of the Lord suffering in Gethsemane, Luke records this. And being in agony, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat were as it were great drops of blood falling down to the ground. According to Luke 22 and 44. As he prayed, he did so with such earnestness. Yeah. That the lines in his forehead began to burst. Sweat and blood mingled together and dropped to the ground. While Jesus Christ is God in the flesh, the body he lived in was a frail human body just like ours.
Yes.
His body knew weariness. His body felt pain.
Yes.
His body felt hunger.
Uh-huh.
His body felt sleepiness.
Yes.
His body felt tiredness.
Uh-huh.
It was just a human body. But as Jesus prayed that night, the emotional and spiritual pressure that came upon Jesus was almost about more than his body could handle. But, somebody said, but, Lord help me to preach here today. But, he handled it. He survived the agony of Gethsemane. And he made it to Calvary. When he died for our sins.
Yes,
can I get a witness here?
Yes.
Somebody ought to say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
And I come to tell you today, sometimes life's pressure can get you in such a point that you feel the frailness of your body. You know weariness. You know what it feels like to have pain. You know what it feels like to be hungry, to be sleepy, and to be tired. But you know what you gotta do. And you found out, like the songwriter wrote, the hymnologist wrote, and I just saw he said, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. Sometimes in this life, we can become so emotional and spiritually under pressure that we don't know nowhere else to turn.
Yeah.
yourself. And tell yourself, self. Call and pat yourself. And tell yourself, self. Don't get up and eat it. Some folk move out of your life. They were only there for just a season. And when they see you, you're up. They gotta move on. Say yes. But I'm glad that I can tell you today that there is a friend that will sit closer than your brother or your sister.
But I gotta hit this point.
Hallelujah.
And so here,
heal now. Praise his holy name.
Yes.
He's gotten to the Gethsemane. He's got 11 of the disciples with him. But he tells 8 of them, stay here at the gate. James, John, Peter, come on with me. Somebody want to say amen.
Hallelujah.
Y'all know how we can get. Why you took them? Why you didn't take me? Why you didn't take us? Sometimes you better be glad you stayed at the gate. Somebody ought to say amen. Somebody ought to say praise the Lord. Sometimes you need to be thankful. You were told, come on and go with me a little further. Because now, when you get past the 8 left at the gate, now some more pressure gets on you because you go a little further with the master. Do I have a witness?
Amen.
Y'all walking with me?
Amen.
I said, y'all walking with me?
Amen.
See, that means he was looking at James, John, and Peter to do some things that the other 8 wasn't going to do. Or the other 8 were not in place to do. And sometimes when you are allowed to go a little further, you tell God, thank you, that I can get here.
Amen.
Because evidently you see something in me that I can get here. I'm not back here, but if I am here, I thank you for blessing me to get at the gate.
Amen.
Do I have a witness?
Amen.
I hope y'all are walking with me. So if you don't mind, just lift your hand and say, thank you, Lord,
for blessing me
to get to the gate.
Because
you could not have got there.
Amen.
Yeah, I said it just like that.
Amen.
The way the old folk were saying, you could not have got there. We pray, the Lord, the proper way. It could have been that you wouldn't not have gotten to the gate.
Amen.
Somebody will say amen.
Amen.
But I'm at the gate.
Amen.
So we say thank God for being at the gate.
Yes.
But now here are the other 3 going with him a little bit further. And when he goes with them a little bit further, he gets to a point and he tells them, y'all stay here. Now watch what he said to them that he didn't say to the 8. He told the 8, stay here. He gets here and told the 3, y'all stay right here and watch with me.
Yes.
Watch with me.
Yes.
Somebody say watch.
Watch
with me. That means stay woke.
That's what it means, Pastor.
You can't watch sleep.
Yes.
I got to point this out.
Yes.
You can't watch napping.
Yes.
None. For somewhere in the none, and napping, you're going to miss what you need. But he told them, watch with me. And then he said, I'm going to go a little. And when he went further, he went by himself. Because now he's in a place where can't nothing be done but something that's going on between him and the Father. Somebody ought to say amen. And sometime in your life, you get to a point where you got to tell others, stay here. I got to go over here. Because this is going to be nobody but me and Jesus. Somebody ought to say amen. You got to have a witness here. See, the only way you're going to make it is you got to get to the point where you know it's you and Jesus. Lord, help me, Jesus.
Oh,
we all been hollering like that. That ain't deep, but it's real. Somebody ought to say amen. Because there are some things in life that mama ain't going to be able to help you. There's some things in life that daddy ain't going to be able to help you. Your brothers, your sisters, your so-called friends, even though your fool ain't going to be able to help you. You got to get to that place where there's nobody but you and Jesus.
Come on now.
When you get there.
Yeah.
I wish I had somebody walking. If you don't mind, just look at a neighbor and tell them,
Daddy!
Jesus and shall believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
Put your hands on my shoulder, please. If you don't mind, amen.
rush through it. Because you don't know what people are going through.
Amen.
You don't know what they're up against.
Amen.
Somebody wants to say amen.
Amen.
Sister Maddie came for her reason. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord knows
amen.
What's going on. Amen. All I need us to do now is get in the pew. So all of these that are up here, I need us to that are believers,
yes.
That believe in the power of prayer, stretch your right or your left hand this way towards them.
Yes.
In the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Strengthen our body. Spirit of mind. So much is on my shoulder. Lord, we know you are able to carry it for. In the name of Jesus. My sister here. You know what you have designed for her life. Touch her, Lord. Strengthen her body. Strengthen her mind. Strengthen her spirit. Bless the Lord for being obedient and making a way to church today. Thank you for doing it in Jesus' name. Say that we want you to know you have no authority. Bow down in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Touch my sister, Lord. So many questions, but we know you're able to answer. So much coming against. Lift the burdens. Free her in the name of Jesus. Make her free in you. We thank you for it. Say the divine power in the name of Jesus. By the divine power of the Lord, we thank you. We bless you. Come on, all of you that agree with me and say, we call it God. In Jesus' name. never seen that before. But on their on the front, on the title, on their name it says D and F.
Yes.
Hands out just like those. Amen. They are able to do just what the deacon government can do.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when they're
out.
Somebody ought to say amen. I'm taking this as a teaching moment.
Yes.
That's what they do. It's just not just this table. But they can help serve this table.
Amen.
Especially in the season of life that they're in at this time. Yeah. Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
Father, we come now to say thank you.
Thank
you. We thank you for this time of coming to this table to remember your death and your suffering till you come again.
Yes,
to partake of that which is symbolic of your body and that which is symbolic of your blood. We ask that you change it from a common to that of a spiritual. In the name of Jesus, that we'll go forward with a deeper determination to let men, women, boys, and girls know that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, we say thank you. We say thank you. We say thank you. Now, Lord, wherever we commit it, wherever we omit it, we ask that you forgive us. Blot out our transgressions. Continue to create within us a clean heart and to renew within us a right spirit in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for the victory. Somebody come on and say it with me. We thank you for the victory. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Join us. We love you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.